21:23. Whoso keepeth his mouth and his tongue, keep his soul from troubles. So how do you get in troubles? When you don't watch your mouth and you don't guard your tongue. The more you just begin to say things. I look at she said a lot and she getting in trouble. Because when you don't watch your mouth, you don't watch your tongue, you getting in trouble. So the Bible said, whoso keep it, shall keep himself from troubles. He said, deceive not with thy lips. I found that in my mind, but I don't know where I found it. He said, deceive not with your lips. Then when you say something to somebody, you want to deceive that person. Then Sudanisha said this about you. Did she go find it? Sudanisha didn't say that about you. Deceiving the person.
Yeah.
Watch what you say.
Amen.
Because why? You ain't the only one eating off your lips. Somebody else eating off what you say. Yeah. You take it out. Somebody else eating off what you say. That wandered from his place. Only perfume rejoice on, so doubt the sweetness of a man's friend by hearty counsel. When you begin to be nice to your friend, he got about yourself. You're talking about you got a heart of counsel against that friend. He's talking about you got to show love, you got to show respect. I can't show Sister Alicia, I can't expect Sister Donisha to show me respect and I ain't showing her respect.
Amen.
He's talking about yourself. You got to gain respect, you got to gain honor. You can't just get it. God ain't just all of a sudden just gonna give you respect. Give you honor and you ain't showing no respect and love to him.
Come on.
He said, "Come by yourself."
Yes, Lord.
The Bible says, Proverbs 18:21, death and life. Everybody know this. Are in the power of the tongue,
and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof.
Yes, Lord.
How do you die? You don't die because you sick.
Uh-huh.
You don't die because you're going through.
Come on.
It's what you speak over your life.
Yeah.
Well, I already know I'm about to go. I'm about to leave this world. Then you're going to die because you just spoke it. He said, death and life is in the power of the tongue.
Yeah.
So if you speak life, you're going to live. But if you speak death, that's what's going to happen to you.
Yes.
Okay, how long you been in a hospital?
Whoa.
If you speak life, you shall live. If you speak that you can get up and walk, you shall walk.
Now,
the Bible said, God's word is not a lie. God said he's not a man that he should lie. He's the son of man that he should repent. So you begin to believe in your heart and you begin to speak with your tongue and with your mouth and say, I shall live. The Bible says you shall live and declare the works of the Lord.
Yeah,
so before you leave this world, you're going to declare the works of the Lord. You got to say that I shall live. I shall get out that wheelchair. I don't have to have nobody holding me. I'm going to walk.
Yeah, man.
I'm going to get up this moment.
Blue.
Because why? It's in the power of your own tongue.
Yeah,
because
yes,
you speak them.
Yes, sir.
If you say that I'm going to die, I feel like I ain't making it. Well, I need a little help. Then you're going to die.
Yes, sir.
Because that's what came out your tongue.
Uh-huh.
Your tongue has power.
Yes,
how many of us know that?
Come on.
Our tongue got more power than we have.
Come on.
Your mouth got more power than what you got.
Yeah.
Your hands ain't got power. It's your tongue. It's your mouth.
It.
So when you try to go fight somebody, think it's all in your hands. It's not in your hands. It's what you say can hurt somebody. So just like my go to study, just because I hit her, she ain't upset because I hit her. She upset because what I said.
Yeah.
He said, come on, yourself.
That's right.
The Bible says in Proverbs 18:20, a man's belly shall be satisfied with the fruit of his mouth, and with the increase of his lips shall he be filled. So whatever you say out your mouth, if it tastes good, you're going to eat of it.
Yeah.
You shall be satisfied with the fruit of your mouth. The fruit of the Spirit. You need to eat of the fruit of the Spirit.
Yeah.
Because why it should taste good to you. When you eat gravel, you eat mess, you eat junk, you eat dirt.
Yeah.
That's nasty.
Yeah, yeah,
and if that's what you eat, that's what your belly gonna be filled with.
Yeah.
You eat a lot of burgers in your side, your stomach, you're gonna have a lot of burgers. You eat a lot of fries, that's what you're gonna have. You eat a lot of attitude, that's what you're gonna have.
Glory. Thank you, Jesus.
The Bible says, Proverbs 25:15, but long forbearance is a prince persuaded, and a soft tongue breaketh the bond. If you see somebody going through, they talking a lot of mess, you just give a soft ounce. I bet they break down.
Yeah,
just talk soft, like a wind just blows. Talk soft, they'll break down. But if you go out there, you acting like them, they gonna keep on doing. Cause I said, I got Sister Tasha to act up. I got her to act in the same way I'm acting.
Yes.
She got on her war clothes. She probably had on the war clothes of God, but she started war clothes of Satan. She dressed like me. I'm trying to find a difference, but we look alike. But we begin to give a soft answer. Well, whatever you say about me, God gonna handle it. That's a soft answer.
Yes. If God said he breaks the bone. So why they look like they're going to begin to break? Everything about them is going to break.
Yeah.
Their flesh is going to soon break.
Gee.
He said, come on, they can't rely on that car.
Mm.
They can't rely on that house.
Jesus.
He said, come on, yes, sir.
Come on.
The Bible says in Proverbs 13:3, he that keep his mouth keep his life, but he that open wide his lips shall have destruction. How can you keep your life from dying? By keeping your mouth.
Yeah.
If you don't want to die yet at the age of 15, if you don't want to die at the age, my age, the age of 22, if you don't want to die at the age of 14, if you don't want to die at the age of 5, if you don't want to die at the age of 54, keep Because if you keep your mouth, it'll keep your life.
Yes, Lord.
He said, come on, yes, said, see, come on, yes. Not saying that the Bible said we all should die.
Yeah.
So what I mean is you won't die
spiritually.
Yeah. Come on. He got on my ass then.
That's right.
Proverbs 26, verse 24 and 28, Proverbs 24, Proverbs 22, Proverbs 20, 17, 15, 13, 10, 25, 23, 21, 18, 16, 14, 12, 8, 5, 4. And Proverbs says, I'll tell you about your mouth and your lips. I searched it out and I wrote it all down. It tell you about your mouth. So there's no excuse when you get to heaven and say, well, you didn't tell me how to control my mouth. But they kept saying this about me. They kept saying this. They kept putting me down. I looked like I was helping everybody, but nobody was helping me.
Yeah.
God will say, read Proverbs. I told you about your lips. I told you about your mouth. Your tongue is all lit down.
Yes,
no excuse. And when you tell you about your mouth, it tells you about your attitude.
Yes,
your mouth tells you about your ways. Your mouth tells you about your actions. So there's no excuse when you die and go to hell that you don't know what you did. Yeah, you didn't tell me none of this. God gonna say you a lie, the truth ain't in you.
Yes.
He come out y'all sell it on my heart. The Bible say, greet one another with a holy kiss. So in order to greet somebody with a holy kiss, Minister Elisha.
Yes,
Lord. In order to greet somebody, you always pray for people. You always do all you can to build up Sister Damish, build up Sister Tasha, build up your sisters, build up Brother Junior, your whole church staff, build up Pastor Dawson. But now we got to learn how to greet you with a holy kiss. I'm going to come to you with my praise. I'm going to come to you with my worship. I'm going to come to you with my thanks. I'm going to come to you with all I got because why I see you hurting. So I'm learning how to greet you.
Yes,
he said, by if you, I'm going to tell you this. If you got attitude in the house of God, God said, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that Jesus is King, that He is Lord, that He's Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last, the rose, the sharing, the great I am, the I am.
Yeah.
He said, everybody, so every tongue going to confess, even Satan unto himself, that's why he got cast out of heaven, because he knew what God was. He knew who God was.
Yeah.
So he tried to get beside himself and get above God, so God had to cast him out of heaven. He said, everybody, so you got to I saw this woman. The Bible said a woman looked out her window, Pharaoh's daughter. He got up and said, and she deceived David in her heart. She got jealous. She got upset because why he was naked. So David found out about it, and he went to the woman. He had to go by and said she was able to bear no more children. So I look at David. He got up and said she got upset. I don't think the Bible says she got upset because his clothes began to fall off. But let me tell you, sir. It wasn't just the clothes. It wasn't just because he was naked. There are a lot of people around him. Women all over there. Men all over here. Women everywhere. So she wasn't upset because his clothes fell off. She was upset because other women saw him.
Yeah.
But you don't supposed to care who looking at your wife, who looking at your husband if they ain't God. If they doing all they can do. So people get jealous of your praise. She was jealous because why? He was doing all he can do and his clothes begin to fall off.
Yeah.
When you begin to take your shoes off, just say, well, I'm going to get out these earrings today. I'm going to loose my head back. I'm right, because I'm taking some part of me out.
Yeah.
You got to get out your flesh.
Yeah.
So I saw that about David. He began to dance and dance and dance. So he began to kick his shoes off. That's why a lot of us, we can't dance without shoes off. He began to kick his shoes off. Everything, his shirts begin to fall off. His pants begin to fall off. And she got upset. She began to see him. He got up by yesterday and said, it's because of the praise, not the nakedness.
Yeah.
It's because she had jealousy against the other women. Well, they all looking at him. Well, I feel like my eyes should be on the one looking at him. She was upset.
Mm.
So don't you know when you begin to praise God, jealousy is lurking. It's always going to be around.
Yeah.
The more you stomp in your feet, the more you clap in your head, death has somebody
nose and trying to watch and say, Debbie praising God, I'm going to do it with him. But she didn't do that. She could have kept back a lot of confusion and she would have got down and joined him.
Amen.
But when you're praising God and you're doing all you can do and somebody back there jealous, they way of being foolish. Let me show you what they do. Instead of come joining you, they talk about you.
Yeah.
Because why? They don't know how to come to you and say, so mother, I want what you got.
Yeah.
I want to do what you do. I see you crying out. You speak to me. Show me how to do it. So they don't want to feel bad about not coming to you. So they talk about you. So that's why now when people talk about me, I don't worry about it. Where the hell is my chair? Where the hell is speaking? Hey, I got a prophecy. I had it. No. I got to do what I got to do right because ain't nobody finna stop me. David didn't care. He didn't get put a curse on her. Because why he had to do what he had to do. So you can't get upset and say, well, they talking about me. They put me down because they don't know how to come to you. That's the way you got to look at. Well, I'm going to respect their attitude. I'm going to respect because I know that they really want to come here and praise God. But maybe I can do something, go get their hand.
Yeah.
When you realize don't want your hand, the Bible said, walk away. He said, shake off the dust of your feet. You go to a house and you try to preach the word of God, they don't want to hear. The Bible said, shake off the dust of your feet, walk off. He said, God, about y'all say, greet one another with a holy kiss. He said,